Windows 10 is the most feature-packed operating system Microsoft has ever released. For your best experience, you should change some default settings and personalize it as you need. In this video, I'm going to show you what are the best settings you should change right now and make it more usable. So, first I'm going to show you how you can show your system hidden files and file extension. For that, we need to go to our control panel. And from here, we can change our view by small icons or large icons. And from this system settings options, we need to go to this file explorer option by click on it. And from this wizard, we need to go to this view section and check this one, show hidden files, for viewing your hidden files. And after that, we need to uncheck this one, hide extensions for known file types, for showing your file extensions. You need to do that for suppose you have downloaded a file from the web and now you want to know what type of file is it. Now, after selecting both of these, click apply and click OK. Let's not forget about in Windows 10, we have two interface options to access our system settings. There is the familiar control panel and a new system settings app for more control of our system. And this app is first appeared in Windows 8, and by every update of Windows, Microsoft is adding more system settings on it. So we are going to cover both of them in this video. Now to the next one, for speed up the shutdown process of Windows 10. Sometimes it takes too long to shut down computer. Before shutdown, the operating system waits too long for exiting any programs. This causes the issue to slow shutdown your PC. But we have a solution for this also. We can speed up this process by setting Windows 10 to kill process and application in short order. For that, we need to go to the register editor by opening the Windows run command. And here we need to write regedit and click OK. And now from here we need to navigate to control by clicking this hkey local machine, click on that and click this system. And now from here we need to click this current control set and click control. And now from here we need to open this wait to kill service timeout by double clicking on it and set its value to 2000. This is the time in milliseconds to kill the running process and apps. Most sites recommend to set this no lower than 2000 so that the system has enough time to shut this process down without causing any problems. Now click OK. And now from here navigate to desktop by clicking this one, hkey current user, and click this one, control panel, and click desktop. And here you need to create a string value by clicking the right button of your mouse and new and click this string value and name it wait to kill app timeout and press enter and double click on it to open it and set its value to 2000 and click OK. And again we need to create a string value and name it hung app timeout and press enter and double click to open it and also set its value to 2000 and again press OK. Now create the last string value and name it auto in task. Press enter and double click to open it and set its value to 1 and press OK. Now for changing your default apps or browsers, for that we need to go to our system settings by clicking this Windows Start menu and click this cog icon. For easy access to our settings app, we can use the keyboard shortcut, hold down the keyboard Windows key and press I button. And here it is, here is the Windows settings app. And from here we need to go to the Windows app settings and from this left hand menu bar, we need to go to this default apps by click on it. And from here we can change our default browser, media player or other default apps. If you prefer other browser than Microsoft Edge, you have to install it on your system first and then you can make it your default browser from here by clicking on it and click this one. I'm going to click this one, Mozilla Firefox, for showing you an example. Now the Mozilla Firefox is my default browser. I can change it anytime from here. You need to create a restore point if you care about your files. If anytime you want to revert your system for its misbehaving without losing your files, It is good to create a restore point for your system. By default, system restore is disabled in Windows 10. For turning it on, first we need to search for restore point. And here it is, create a restore point. We need to open it by click on it. Make sure you are in the system protection tab. Now, from here, you need to select your boot drive. In normal case, it should be in the C drive. After selecting your boot drive, click configure and make sure that turn on system protection is checked. Now, for disk space usage, it is good to put higher than 6GB. Mine is 10GB and it is 10% of my total disk space. You can increase or decrease the space by sliding this one right or left. After selecting your disk space, click apply and click OK. And again click OK. Now, for showing default desktop icons, we need to go to the Windows settings, and from here we need to go to the personalization by click on it, and from this left hand menu bar we need to go to this theme, and from here we need to click this desktop icon settings. And from this wizard, I can select which app I want to add to my desktop home screen. I'm going to select this control panel so I can access to my control panel very easily from my desktop home screen. Now, after selecting, click apply and click OK to add them. Now, for personalizing your PC, first we need to go to our personalized settings. We can go to our personalization settings very easily from our desktop by clicking the right button of our mouse and click this one, personalize, and be sure about which tab are you in from the personalization. And from this background section, we can change our background image, and also we can change its fit to fit, stretch, tile, center or span. Fill is better. In every section of settings, we have a right menu bar in here. We can go to our related settings from here, or we can get frequently asked questions answer. Now, after selecting your background image and choose a fit, we need to go to the color option. And here I can see a lot of color in here. I can select this one, automatically pick an accent color from my background. By selecting it, your desktop will automatically detect a color from your background image and select it as your taskbar or start menu colors. And here you can see all of my colors are now matching to my background image. Now go down, and here you can see we can also add this transparent effect. I already added my transparent effect. After turning it off, you can see how it looks. Now from this show accent color on the following surfaces, I can select if I want to add my accent color to my taskbar or action center. I can uncheck this one, and here you can see the default taskbar color, and here you can see the default start menu color. I am going to check this one. And from here, you can also choose your default app mode. Light, it is defaulted by Windows 10, and dark, you can switch to dark. And here you can see my dark app mode. Now I'm going to switch to light. Now after selecting all of them, go to lock screen. And from here, you can add any app to your lock screen or disable them. And also you can set up this Cortana lock screen settings or screen timeout settings from here and screen server settings. You can click any of these to open more options. Here you can see other options. Now going back and now going to themes. And from here, you can select your background images, colors, sounds or mouse cursor. You can select which type of mouse cursor you want from here by clicking on it, and here you can see all of my mouse cursors. I can add any of them. Now cancel. And from here we can also add more themes to our Windows 10. If we are not happy with our default themes, we can also get more themes in Microsoft Store by click on it, and here you can see a lot of themes are in here. Most of them are free and some of them are paid. You can select any of them to add to your Windows 10 PC. Now go to fonts, and here you can see all of your installed fonts on your Windows, and going to start. And from here we can add more tiles to start, and here you can see it is big now. And show app list in start menu, we can also off that, so we are not going to see our app lists in here. After that, we can select this one, show recently added apps. We can uncheck this one or show suggestions occasionally in start or you start full screen. We can select this one, you start full screen, to make our start menu full screen. And here you can see that my start menu is now full screen. I'm going to uncheck this one. And now by clicking this one, choose which folders appear on start. You can select which folders you want to add to your start. And here you can see that the folders, I'm going to select this one, downloads. So you can see that here it is, the downloads. I can access to my downloads from here very easily. Now going back, now going to taskbar, and from here I can select automatically hide taskbar in desktop mode. I can select this one, and here you can see that my taskbar is hidden when I hover over to the bottom and it is pops open. Now I'm going to uncheck this one, and here you can see more other options to select or change. We can also turn system icons on or off. And here you can see I can add any of these system icons to my taskbar. Now I'm hiding my clock. You can hide any of this, hide or show any of these icons. Now going back. Now to our Cortana search bar. It is time to show you how you can change the view of your Cortana search bar. If you opened a lot of apps and your taskbar is full of apps and you need some extra space on your taskbar, you can simply hide your taskbar search icon by clicking the right button of your mouse in your taskbar and go to Cortana and select this one, show Cortana icon or hide them. I'm going to select this one, show Cortana icon, and here you can see our Cortana icon is here. We can access our Cortana search bar by clicking on it and search anything in here, and here you can see, or we can hide them as well by clicking this one, Cortana, and click this one, hidden. We can still search anything by going to start menu and write anything in here. So suppose I'm going to write restore, and here you can see that I can also search from my start menu. So this is the video of how you can personalize your Windows 10 by changing some default settings. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, and if you got any question about this video or about this process, you can ask me in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to answer that, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for getting free learning videos like this one. So stay tuned to get more. Thank you for watching and have good times.